Good evening and welcome to St. John the Evangelist Parish this first Sunday of Lent. Please stand and join in singing our opening song, Led by the Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God, the gifts of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome as we begin our first Sunday of the Lenten season. We hear Jesus' iconic words, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." And so let us prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, asking forgiveness for our sins.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." God added, "This is the sign that I am giving for all ages to come of the covenant between me and you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living things, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord.
Your ways, O Lord, Reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, Christ suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. In it, he also went to preach to the spirits in prison, who had once been disobedient, while God patiently waited in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism which saves you now. It is not a removal of dirt from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord.
Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
One does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes forth from the mouth of God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King. Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The Spirit drove Jesus out into the desert. And Jesus remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John the Baptist had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This past Thursday, we had a funeral of one of our former parishioners, 95-year-old Ernie, who used to sit way in the back there. And his family chose a gospel for his funeral mass that in the 43 years I've been officiating funerals, we never had proclaimed. And it was also from Mark's gospel. But later on in Mark's gospel, today we begin in chapter 1 for Ernie's funeral mass. It was chapter 15, the crucifixion. And there we heard Jesus proclaim, "Father, how is it that you have disregarded me?" And then he dies. But immediately after that gospel in chapter 15, we then hear how the women go to the tomb early in the morning. How are we going to turn the stone away? Where is Jesus? The stone is gone. Jesus is gone. There's a man dressed in white. You're looking for Jesus. He's not here. He is risen. That's the end of the Lenten season and moves right into Easter. And today's gospel is the beginning of the Lenten season, as we hear Jesus is driven out into the desert, driven by the Spirit. No time to prepare. Just go. The angels will take care of you. The angels will take care of you when you're tempted by Satan, when you are hungry, when the wild beasts come lurking. 20 years ago this year, I went hiking to the bottom of the Grand Canyon. We had 8 months to prepare to hike in this desert experience. And the four pieces of advice from the National Park said, wear good hiking boots, have a good backpack, take 4 gallons of water, and wear a nice sombrero. Keep the sun off your nose. So we had time to prepare and the hike went well, but here Jesus is driven. No time to go to Cabela's. No time to run home. Just go into the desert. And because he is there, protected by the angels, he survives the temptations. He survives the hunger. He survives the thirst. And what do we have at the end of the gospel is he leaves the desert and he goes and begins his public ministry as the divine human Son of God. Repent. The kingdom of God is at hand. And so as we gather on this first full weekend of the Lenten season, this is the message also for us, that we too are called to be a people to repent, that these 40 days of Lent is our invitation to enter the desert, to pray, to fast, to give alms, to fast from all those things that may be excessive in our life. Yes, to get rid of the extra eating, to get rid of all the unnecessary screen time, to get rid of all the unnecessary anger, to get rid of all the unnecessary entertainment, all the extra noise, all the extra news, all the sin. May we spend these days ridding our lives. And know that like Jesus, he and we are not alone. But as the church teaches us in the catechism, we have this great gift of our guardian angels to guide us, to strengthen us, to lead us on the path to holiness, that we may truly become more ourselves, children of God. On Ash Wednesday, if you weren't here, we passed out, and we again will pass out at the end of this Mass, this little booklet we're giving out in this year of the Eucharistic Revival. It's called Beautiful Eucharist. 12 stories by 12 different people, simple little stories, maybe 3 to 5 pages of how they come to believe and accept that Jesus is truly present in the Eucharist, body, blood, soul, and divinity. It's a great read for yourselves as a family, as a couple, as an individual, that as we journey through the desert of Lent, that we may grow ever more fully appreciative with a greater awareness with our minds and hearts involved, that as we come to Mass, it is not a time to be entertained, but it is a time to receive the goodness, the grace of Christ. Just a word of caution that comes out of the life of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. Here's a man who was a great sinner, a great warrior, a womanizer, in bed recovering, and he has this huge conversion, so he wants to give his whole life. So being in bed with his broken leg was sort of his desert experience, and he became inflamed with the love of Christ, the church, the lives of the saints, and he comes to this point in his conversion process and says, Lord, I'm going to give all to you. My mind, my body, my soul, all for you. And at that moment, Satan, he says, comes in with this most negative thought. Ha, Ignatius, you're a man, a great sinner. Just look back at your sinful life. There is no way you are going to grow in holiness. There's no way you can commit your life to Christ for the rest of your life. And he fell in immediate depression. How true this message was. A great sinner. One of the reasons why it's not always good to recount our sins that we have confessed. But then the truth enlightened his mind. He said, I might not have my whole life for conversion, but he says, I have today. Today, I can live a holy life. And for the next 50 years, he indeed lived a holy life to become this great saint. Even 500 years, he continually rises to inspire men and women to grow in holiness. Today we embark on the first full week of the Lenten season. Like on Ash Wednesday, we are called to pray, to fast, to give alms, to die to our excessive living, that we might, like Jesus, die, but also rise to new life. May we keep our eyes and hearts fixed on the goal, and that is that we may die with Christ, that we, like him, may rise with Christ to new and everlasting glory. Let us rise as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come.
Amen. To God who promises and desires holy life for us, we pray our needs in confidence.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Listecki, and all the baptized, that the Church may show the world the way to God through repentance and prayer. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
that world leaders may work together to seek peace and justice for all. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That through our Lenten practices we may grow closer to God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those suffering from illness, especially Marlene, and old age, may have gentle caregivers to attend to them and ease their pain. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of our parish family may renew our covenant with God through sacrifice, reconciliation, and prayer. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may all be inspired by the Holy Spirit to serve and protect all life from conception to natural death. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, religious life, holy marriage, and permanent diaconate. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may rest in the loving presence of the saints and angels, including parishioners Mary Ann Seepluck and Janice Game, who died recently, and Chase Stephen Frelk, who will be baptized this weekend, and for the members of St. John's Parish for whom this Mass is offered, and for those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we give you thanks for these days in the desert of 40 days. May our faithfulness lead us ever closer to you. We ask this in all our prayers through Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Give us the right disposition, O Lord, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. By abstaining 40 days from earthly food, Jesus consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance. And by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, Jesus taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal heavenly feast. And so with angels and saints, we sing your praises. You are indeed holy, O Lord, you are the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and confess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Jerome, our Archbishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord Jesus always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. I get the Jesus. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to share in the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Your people with love.
merciful God, light when the shadows of life cloud our view. Feed us in thy doors, merciful God, people who hunger for you.
Surely you alone uphold us.
You give us strength for all.
The King.
kingdom is at hand. Repent, the kingdom is at hand. Forgive one another, now the acceptable time.
Now the acceptable time.
Hello, and thank you, Father Michael, for giving me this opportunity to speak to all the men of St. John Evangelist Parish. As being a standing member with the team leadership for the Men of Christ Conference, I would like to let you know about the upcoming conference scheduled for Saturday, March 9th. You are all invited, young and old, to join in fellowship for the 2024 Men of Christ Conference titled Mastering What Matters. It will be held in parishes live streamed across the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, Joliet, Illinois, New York, and even the country of Portugal. You ask, how can this be? Well, it starts with a simple conversation with a coworker, a friend, a relative, a neighbor. This year it was decided to take several smaller attending parishes and join them all together to have a larger fellowship with like-minded men. We will be joining with St. Leonard's Parish in Muskego, who will be hosting the event this year at their parish gathering center and inside the church. The day will start with 7:05 rosary and mass at 7:30. There will also be confessions held throughout the event. The program will kick off at 8:45 a.m. with such great speakers as the very Reverend Archbishop Jerome Lestecki, Father John Lococo, Father Mark Bernhardt from the Archdiocese of Joliet, Illinois, along with Dave Duran, Sam Blair, and Kevin O'Brien. The program is scheduled to wrap up around 1 p.m. If you would like more details regarding the speakers or the event, please visit the website at themenofchrist.net and also to register for the conference. Please note when registering for the conference to click on the St. Leonard Parish, but join as a St. John Evangelist Parish member. If you have any questions, I'll be in the back of church. I'll be in the back after church. There will also be an insert in next week's bulletin. I would greatly like to see a large presence from St. John Evangelist. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you. And our other announcements.
Every Wednesday during Lent, please join us for the Stations of the Cross at 6:30 p.m. in the church. This weekend, the Respect Life Committee has spiritual adoption cards in the narthex after all masses. Please take a card for each member of your family and pray daily for an unborn girl or boy during Lent. The St. John's Men's Group will continue its Your Lenten Journey program on Saturdays during Lent. Sign up in the narthex. The St. John's School is holding a Compassion and Action Drive during Lent. This week, they are collecting basic health and hygiene products. See the bulletin insert for details. The Word Among Us for Lent is available in a narthex. The cost is $2 each, and script will be sold after all masses.
Let us pray. renewed now with heavenly bread, we, by which faith is nourished, hope increased, and charity strengthened, Lord God, we pray that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread from heaven. Jesus, Lord, forever and ever. Amen. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and errors of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of Heavenly Host, Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Our Lady of Sorrows,
pray for us.
If you weren't able to pick up a beautiful Eucharist book on Ash Wednesday, please do so in the back of church this evening. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Go forth to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Teach us, gracious Lord, to